And while he's doing that, I'm Carter here on Color. Welcome back to everyone who joined us last week for the 4th of July pay-per-view. And we're deeply sorry for all the nudity on that show. Needless to say, the Muppets won't be invited back anytime in the near future. Wonder what Daz is up to. Uh-oh. Things are getting heated. If you have any suggestions on what Dad should say to the person he's speaking to on the phone, please come to visit the Twitch chat and give all of your most colorful suggestions. I mean, they're interrupting the show. Whoever's calling him ought to get an earful. But in all seriousness, thank you so much for joining us. Going to be a pretty exciting show this week. We've got as always, our bar brawl to start with. Just an absolute, always a crowd pleaser. Just can't stress that enough. It's always fun. Welcome back. Hey, what I tell you, audience, we got that coming up. Yeah, away we go. Oh, whip rack with a stunner out of nowhere. There go the chops. Rodriguez is going for a, going for a quick start. Oh! Enziguri. Oh! Uncle Slam. Center of the ring. And... oh, good grief. Was that a... I thought that was ankle lock that went critical. Who critted? Well, somebody seems to have survived a crit, which is a miraculous feat of toughness. Ooh. That sounds about right for old Mikey. Yep. To Brian Pillman and Mikey Whipwreck, two wrestlers who left us too soon. Is that Koloff? Which Russian guy is that? Oh, okay. True. Yeah, kinda. Oh, I didn't realize Nikolai Volkov had passed away in 2018. Had some memorable feuds, famously turned face when Sergeant Slaughter sided with Saddam. And, here comes Volkov breaking up his, he sure did. Now that is some quality yelling. Oh. There's so much going on, I didn't even see who got bonked. Ah, jeez. Oh, this is kind of messed up. Whipwreck and Pillman are the first two out of the Battle Royale. I mean, Rodriguez misses the leg lock. Oh! Nice back suplex. Volkov gets out of the guillotine choke. So does Saber. Oh. Torture twist. Rodriguez gets out of it. Oh! That would be 15 yards in the NFL, a clip like that. Volkov is, in trouble. Riga's on a rampage. Right over into that power head and arm hold. Oh. I'd watch a lot more MMA if everyone did the Wilhelm scream all the time. I can tell you that much. Oh, Rodriguez did not come out on top in that exchange, and now pendulum backbreaker. Combo of hits on Rodriguez and another deadly backbreaker from Volkov. And Rodriguez leaves via cocky pin. Volkov is not leaving yet. He has a lot more to say to these young whippersnappers. Oh, you can feel that from here. We finally sent Volkov home for the evening. And, oh. Black. None of the men in the ring look, look very fresh. Hello? Come on. What? What got run over? I see. Yep. That's pretty much the size of it. Boom, down he goes. And another neck breaker. Everyone trades blows and hits the floor. Oh. Blazing fists take over the match. And, eats a power slam. Interesting. Oh. Either one of these men is going to be a fierce champion based on this display. Could be minutes away from finding out. Oh, nicely done. Three out of four hits landed completely successfully. Very good weapon use. Uh-oh. Double underhook does not enough to overcome the difference in raw strength. Oh! Now, big man splatters against the steel railing. And big chair upside the head. Oh. This could go either way. We have a hardcore duel. Oh! Not... I don't know, but... Maybe he's trying to make it up the turnbuckle, I'm not sure. That one. All right, with a power slam, we have the new champion. Yes, that was a very poor decision on his part, and at that point in the match, it's taken Acrobat to perform a feat like that. That man, he was not in top condition by the end of that match. No one was, but one of them was the winner, and for him, it's all worth it. Nice. And featuring Colt Cabana, one of the great practitioners of British style pro wrestling. So it's not just a flag. And on the other side of the ring, of course, is British strongman Brian Bat. Welcome aboard. Wow, Cabana overpowers Battler to start with. And, oh, big elbow. Reverses whatever he was trying to do, but doesn't capitalize. Battler's back in control. Oh no, there goes another suplex. Simple but effective. Alright. Taking the elbows to him, Dusty Rhodes style. And almost goes out of the ring, not quite. Go past each other. Ooh. Another suplex power slam. Big boot misses, and now we're in a slugfest. Colt has him in the center of the ring, but Battler sprawls out, pushes Colt against the canvas, and now we're back to locking up. Oh, goodness. A choke slam and a fist drop. Alright, we'll see what Colt Cabana can answer that with. And a steamroller. And a spinning clothesline from Battler. Yes, Battler just had some very strong offense. But the suplexes... Colt just keeps landing those. Oh! Yes, indeed. And what's Colt doing now? Ooh. Now, second time he's gone to town on Battler that way this match. He's been keeping the big man on the run. Meatloaf. In terms of pure thickness, Cabana's probably the big man in this match, I should say. But Battler is clearly more built. Yes. Another chin lock. Simple but effective. You can end a fight with that. Oh. Well, that can't please Battler very much. Adding actual insult to injury. Oh! And coming back with a... Not quite. Simple but effective. One of the oldest tricks in the book. Oh, another back to belly pile driver from Cabana. Another dash straight from Battler. Don't like his chances, Nas. Wow. Perseverance in the face of a pretty technically sound and tenacious offense from Cabana. That could have gone either way. You talked to me 5 minutes ago, I would have bet on Cabana easy. Not that I bet on any of this. So he gets Aries Alexander. How so? With the GWA audience, we'll see how viral his virility can go. Whoa! Whatever happened to Christopher Daniels? Did he finally become an actor? Oh, good for him. Now, this is a great stand-up game so far in this match. Both these men are equipped with a variety of deadly strikes. And I think he did feel the power. There we go, from the enziguri to the eye pokes. And now the eye rake. Oh! Another out of nowhere roundhouse to the face. One of those could end this fight instantly. Oh! Obadiah doesn't like doing anything nice. And feel the power. Absolute, unrepentant, constant ball crushing. Oh! The sitting jumping tombstone. He might have, that might have been the right move, getting off the turnbuckle there. Jumping headbutt. Two. Three more shoulders to the arm. Oh! Open palm strike uppercut. A face buster and a flashing elbow. Ambitious. Oh! He didn't check his feet, ref. He could have been in the ropes. Is in the ropes that time. Oh! Another DDT. Oh. Out of nowhere with that sidekick. Has Shinya Hashimoto quality. Oh. Three of those elevated DDTs. And then a sliding Kenka kick. I can't say I'm too surprised. That was a relentless assault. Now he could have his win vacated for that. The Dark Death Drop lived up to its name, and I'll be right back.
doing, bitch?
Business as usual. Good evening. I don't think it's going to work. A chop fest worthy of Kobashi and Joe. Not this time. We made it up. Nice roundhouse to the face. Amazing flexibility. He rolled out of the grapple without doing his little dance, or is that only the other guy who does that? See why not? It'd be weird not to. And oh, fancy roll up does not get him that time. One. Interesting. Huh. I didn't know Michael Elgin was married to Ms. Chiff. That's cool. I gotta pound something. Not this time. Another code red. Misses in Zagiri. And the spinning elbow, and another spinning elbow. He is going to wear himself out. Yep, not this time. Very crisp knees to the midsection. and another one. He needs some help. Oh, he helps himself. Oh. Oh, a sudden, that's hard to watch. I'm truly, some amazing hip action on that dance. Nasty clothesline. Excuse me. Not this time. Now, Starman style flip kick, but it's still not enough. He is in the wrong corner with a... Uh-oh. Oh yeah. Oh. I don't know how he's hiding a sickle or where. This time the interference goes against them. Ooh, yeah. And this week's workshop shout out goes to James Ra, who he has a collection with all of his moves, so it's easy to subscribe to them all. He's made over 200 moves for Fire Pro. They look good. And oh, well, oh, yes, indeed. Interesting. Yeah, it's a hard win over a fierce team. It's very possible. But on the other hand, they had Big E in their corner, and unfortunately, he was Big E. This is a crossbody. That did not go Hijo del Santo's way. Oh, a crowd got fired up by that Boston crab. Backdrop leaves him open, but a brawl breaks out. Inverted head scissors followed by the back body drop. And successfully lures him to the corner. And the big boot. Narico nails him with that elbow, but gets hit with the full rotation drop kick shortly thereafter. Somersault senton. Another head scissors from Narico. Here we go. He still did the damage, though. Spinning brainbuster. No, not even close. Tremendous technical execution by El Generico on that roll-up. Well. The son of the saint got a taste of his own medicine, and now he's sending Generico outside. Big kick to the face, and a diving headbutt. But there comes a jumping suplex from Generico. And this could be another splash. Yeah. Oh. What was that? Nicely done. Well, this should be a fun match. It's colorful. Hot toe hold. And no feeling out period for Malefic Hollow. But there is the arm drag and back fist. Wipes him silly. These men don't give up. More beautiful kicking action from Malefic Hollow. Yes, indeed. Big arm drag out of nowhere. Not quite. More knees to the face. Misses the kick. Another super kick. Wow, what a combination. Now those wrist locks. Make him wrench your whole arm out of its socket. Dragon screw into a fist drop and gets out of the way. Yep, that. Oh! Hammers him in the leg. Not this time. Now, no one looks good when they've been thrown out of the ring like that. Oh, beautiful. He had that cinched in perfectly. There was no escape. That might be match of the night for me. I gotta say. Interesting. Oh, he's been on quite a tear lately. Did not avail him out of that axe kick. Still got nailed in the back of the head. Oh! What an arm drag. Wow. Beautiful Delta World backslide. Excellently executed. Bridging figure four. Excellently done as usual. Uh-oh. Now a inverted figure four. He's setting him up for a corner move. Not yet. Ooh, there goes the sidewalk slam. That's a great, great hold. Oh, Gorilla Press Cutter. Not quite. These men still have a lot to say. Oh. Another knockdown drag out. This could do it. It didn't. It could have, but it did. Oh, crap. Eiffel the Tower does it. Oh, yes. I would be surprised. Nice. Oh, it should be Conan in the corner. That could change things. Thank you. Hey.
Orgullosamente Latino hasta la muerte y después. Worldwide Latino pride. The ambassadors of violence. LAX, K-Dog, the notorious 187 homicide.
Fight!
Flips him right over to start with, but he's in the wrong corner. But now he's been, nope, not anymore. He is leaving LAX's corner. Not a moment too soon. But what's he? Oh, just missed. Oh. Two major moves in a row stopped in their tracks, and oh, manages to win a fist fight with Garrick Mason, is no mean feat. They're not going to let the masked men pull off any of their moves, it looks like. Oh, finally. Got the back suplex STO combo going. Oh, another one. Nope. Breaks him down into the armbar. And the very tall Garrick Mason lands a huge arm drag. That's got a rattle him. An homicide comes back with a devastating suplex. I guess someone's got to. He misses the low-level dropkick. But there goes the Tiger Spin. And that's what they tell you. Powerbomb neckbreaker. Mason is a sitting duck for the frog splash. Oh, there goes the SOS. What an impact. Not yet. And that could be pivotal. Pendulum backbreaker. That did not go as planned. Oh, Jesus. Flips off the top rope and drags him down to a massive powerbomb. Mason makes a fiery comeback. I think everyone's a little caught up in the moment. Who's up first? Oh, Garrick is. Just wails on the back of his head a few dozen times. German suplexes him right off the mat and paves a way for that was a tremendous opportunity for Homicide. He's capitalizing perfectly. This could be the end. Yeah, once you a frog splash and a belly to back pile drive, back to back pile driver. Excuse me. Oh, this is our main event. I see. Good evening, everyone. Hope you're still enjoying the show. Seeing some excellent wrestling tonight. And I'm back. What did I miss? Doesn't sound like much anything.
Fight!
And I'm back. Joe and Taz. Oh, sure. One over Taz will open a lot of doors for you. Oh, yes. Both men are bleeding quite freely. Yeah, so Taz's mission is a pretty strong choke that synergizes really well with his arsenal of deadly suplexes. But he won't. Not yet. We're still 18 minutes away from 0 hour. There's plenty of match to go. Is this gonna be what does it? Not quite. Oh, another Death Valley driver. Light tube miraculously doesn't break. What was that in the background? Yep. What's it called? What, like kitchen clutch? Sounds like a Spanish word for kitchen. Oh, gigantic German. Nope. Not this. Not gonna get him that way this time. No. No, Taz is reaching down deep. He is fighting out of this somehow. He sure did, right on cue, almost. Yeah, no kidding. Hi, Mr. Varence. Good. Yeah. Need something for the kids. Landmines. Good. Huh? I can't believe you talked to your dad like that. Oh. Huh? Oh, yeah. My favorite. Ah. Mick Foley, maybe my favorite wrestler of all time. Gonna do it classic style. Yes, indeed. Oh, the spirit rush. And Foley's down, but not before leaving his mark. Well, that'll happen when you get thrown into a landmine. Yeah, there's been some real wild stuff going down. All the usual suspects are here, and a few new faces. Oh! And Foley sends him outside again. Is going to take this one. Oh my. Right onto the hammer. Yeah, the floor, at least the floor is flat. Right into the wire. And Jack hit with his own DDT. Sure does. Is the pulling pile driver. Another elevated DDT. Now, there ain't many people harder to knock over. Well, I don't think, if there's one thing Cactus Jack's not afraid of, it's the sight of his own blood. Yes, Moxley might have made a tactical error sending him out like that. Another pile driver. Kitchen sink drops Moxley, and Cactus Jack looks around to figure out what he's got at his disposal. Brainbuster onto the chair. Both men dazed. Have to go a long way to find a couple of guys with less quit in them than these two. Oh, back to the center of the ring. What is this leading to? Oh! Ah, Cactus Jack eats his own double arm DDT, but he comes right back. There he goes, upside the head. Yes, indeed. Moxley just can't keep his blood inside. Nicely done reversal. Avoids a very bad fall. Oh! Ah! DDTs don't get any easier to watch. Wow, what a display of machismo. Oh! Ah! They are running out of time. Even so, they're acting like their bodies aren't going to give out any second now. Oh! Another big kitchen sink from Cactus Jack. Ah, flush hammer shot. What a sickening thud that made. Moxley avoids a bad trip and manages to stack Jack on his head. But Cactus Jack never dies. That's exactly the kind of impact that could change, break the stalemate. Another devastating knee strike from Cactus Jack. Ow! This is a absolutely savage display. He can't take a lot of abuse. We might need another ref. Oh. Another DDT. You sure did. Oh, no, not again. This has been an epic confrontation. In every sense of the word. John Moxley is struggling against this legend like Beowulf wrestling Grendel. There will be no respite. Another spirit rush. It's just these two men are so focused and so dedicated. It's like holding on it's like when you touch an electric wire and you can't let go of stuff. It's just not going to end until one of these men's bodies completely gives out. At long last. Jesus Christ. Well, as a massive Cactus Jack fan, that's probably my match of the night. Maybe my favorite match in the history of the GWA. What an insane slugfest. Oh, yes. Yeah, that was an actual bloodbath. There's no topping that. Jesus Christ. What a match. And Moxley, for his part, did a tremendous job standing up against a bona fide legend. It was good family fun. Bring everybody around to watch the VOD. One of those two. Your other Pacific. Thank you.